greetings from Tokyo. That's right, Tokyo.
Okay, so I'm not in Tokyo, but I'm back for vlog number 4.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I may not be in Tokyo, but I am one step closer. My passport came in the mail, which really surprised me and threw off all my plans, because there's a really big, like, passport crisis going on right now, and I thought my passport wasn't going to get here until, like, December, October, whatever. I don't even know the order of my months, but, I have it here. For those of you who have never had a passport, comes in this thing, priority mail, and inside of it, the passport, and then it comes with this flyer thing. I know you can't see what it says, but it says, with your U.S. passport, the world is yours. And then on the back, right here, it's supposed to have this little card, but I took it off. I guess it's like if you lose your passport or something. Like, it says write passport number and passport expiration date, and keep separate from your passport. They're allergic to each other, they'll die. Yeah, I don't know, whatever, I haven't filled it out yet. And then, my passport. I feel so cool having a passport. Okay, and then there's this new thing they have, it's like all patriotic, doo-doo-doo. And I took a really, really bad picture. Look. See? But, you know what? I wasn't surprised. I took a really bad picture. I was surrounded by so many stupid people that way, and I hate stupid people. I hate annoying people. I hate stupid people. It drove me crazy. I took a video just of how annoyed I was. Look at this. This is my actual reaction. Wasn't I just full of joy and love that day? Yeah, I'm just glad it's over with. I was there for about 6 hours just to get my passport, but I got my passport. ID plus passport, or ID equals passport equals Tokyo. Look at my first vlog and you'll see what I'm talking about. Hopefully I'll leave maybe late October, early November, because that's kind of what I was planning for. And I don't know, this passport really threw off all my plans, so let's see what happens. Yeah, I'm really going to miss a lot of my friends and family. And a lot of people are thinking, you know, oh, he's not going to do it. You know, it's too hard to leave. And sorry to bust your bubble, but yeah, I'm leaving. This is my dream, and I can't stand being in my house anymore. I need to live on my own now. Like, I love my parents, and I love my family, but I can never live in this house again. But anyway, yeah, I think the person I'm going to miss most is my best friend, Jason. I actually spent the weekend with him at his house. Like, we used to do that every summer back when I lived at my grandma's house, which was right next to his house, but whatever. And I recorded some video so you guys can see what we did, because we're stupid. Yeah.
Recording.
Like that. We're at the computer store.
Hi, Jason. Before I leave to Japan, I'm gonna get that camera.
Just for you.
Look at the fat. Look at the fatness. Oh my god, it's horrible.
Alright, score is 2-5. Two to six. 2-7. You lose, game over.
Yeah, a lot of people comment on me in Japan, like, why do you love Japan so much? And what's so special about Japan? And to tell you the truth, I don't know. I just like it. okay, why do you like air? Because it keeps you alive? You don't know, you just breathe it. Yeah, I guess it started with video games, probably like Metal Gear Solid, and then it mutated to anime, and then from there I just loved the language, and I tried learning the language, and I didn't do a very good job, but now I actually am learning. And yeah, and I also love like their personality, like their little like, oh, suge, oh, oh, like their little cute things that they do. Plus, I'm a hardcore technology geek. I'm just a geek in general, although I may not look like one. And I love all the weird stuff that they have. I don't know. Japan just, it goes with me. If you hung out with me long enough, you'd be able to tell me, oh yeah, it goes with you. But yeah, and I actually just bought a pair of rollerblades. I used to rollerblade a lot when I was a kid, but I haven't done it in years. And I used to be able to do a lot of tricks and stuff, and you lose it if you don't use it, let me tell you. Yeah, because some people get around walking, most people, some people use bikes, and I wouldn't dare get a car, because, yeah, that's a long story. But I got rollerblades, because that's how I would like to get around Tokyo. And, yeah, this, I don't know if you can see it, was actually my first attempt at doing a simple trick. As soon as I got my rollerblades, and I just wiped out, and I completely skid, like my dad saw everything, it was bad. But, yeah, so I tested out my rollerblades, and they were really fun.
There's a man who leads a life of danger. To everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. Chance he takes, odds are he won't live to see tomorrow. Secret agent man, they've given you a number and taken away your name.
All right, my friends, that was my fourth vlog. And I'm sorry it was a couple days late, I didn't really have much for this vlog, sorry it wasn't that entertaining, but, yeah, that's pretty much it. Peace, love, and Rick James. Is that how it goes? No. Chuck Norris. Peace, love, and Chuck Norris. Sayonara. Mata ne.